Bonjour everyone, welcome back to our channel. My name is Colinda and together with my husband Jeroen and our three kids Luca, Fleur and Jules, we live in the southwest of France, in the Lot-et-Garonne region, named after the two biggest rivers that flow through it. We fell in love with this region after our first visit here back in 2015. The landscape is just gorgeous, with all the rolling hills and small villages. In 2022, we took the leap to move from the Netherlands to here, and we bought an old farmhouse, which needs a lot of renovation. So that's what we document here on this channel. I want to thank all of you for the support on this small channel. For every view, like and comment, it means a lot to us and keeps us motivated to pursue our dream. At the end of January, our terrace looked like this. We had just made the new plant borders. But how cute is that little squirrel? And see how it looks now at the end of March. We planted the plants just 3 weeks ago. In this border, we have replanted some verbena. And over here, we've planted some new rosemary and viburnum. In the last border, we've planted lavender. I can't wait to see how it looks in just a few months when the verbena and lavender are in blossom. And now it's time for some renovation. One of the latest tasks before painting and decorating our son's bedroom is laying the new floor. It's a job that Jeroen didn't do alone, but with some help from me. He was responsible for cutting the tiles and bringing on the glue, and I laid the floor. For all our bedrooms, we've opted for a travertine floor. A deliberate choice because there is used to be wood flooring in place. The previous owners later covered the wooden floor with a vinyl floor. Unfortunately, the wooden floor was completely moldy due to moisture problems in our house. We hope that with a stone floor, we'll have fewer issues. The inspiration for our travertine floor came from this photo on Pinterest. Although they didn't use travertine here, but more of a terracotta tile. We also considered this option, but eventually chose travertine tiles in the same size as the inspiration photo. The weather is getting a bit warmer again, so we can have lunch outside again. So nice. Here in France, it's very common to have a warm meal at lunchtime. At first, we had to get used to this a lot, but now we're completely used to it and find it now strange to quickly eat a sandwich or something like that for lunch. Yes, finally done after hours of work. We forgot to film the grouting, but hey, that was also quite a bit of work, taking an hour or more. And yes, after a few hours, the least enjoyable part begins, cleaning the floor to remove the grout residue. On our property, we have several large trees that really needed pruning. It wasn't an easy task because Jeroen didn't feel comfortable using a chainsaw while sitting in a treetop. So everything had to be done by hand with a handsaw.
Ja, het was ook niet zo lekker weer, nee. Echt veel te veel.
We decided to paint our walls with lime paint, this time in a neutral color that came about through the sand color we mixed ourselves. Back in the Netherlands, we had lime paint on several walls in our house, but we usually bought ready-made colors from brands like Pure and Original. However, this time we decided to mix the lime paint ourselves for cost reasons. You can also add pigments to get a different color, which we bought already, but we haven't tried it yet. Maybe we will test it in our own bedroom. We like ready-made lime paint, because you know that the color is always the same, but it's so much more expensive than mixing it yourself. Lime paint really gives a beautiful, authentic effect on the walls, and that's why we like using it. Plus, it's good for the walls, because it allows them to breathe. At night, after renovating or finishing work, Jeroen and I relax on the couch, watching YouTube channels about people who moved to new countries, like or channels of people who, like us, are heavily involved in renovations. We've discovered that there are actually a lot of Dutch, Belgian and English people who have made big changes in recent years, and many of them have started YouTube channels where they document their renovation adventures. They all speak English on their channels. Some, like us, live in France, but there are also several in other countries, such as Italy and Norway. So here are a few of our favorite channels to follow. Marloes from French Country Life. She is also from the Netherlands and lives in Burgundy with her husband Olaf, who have his own Dutch YouTube channel. Jenny and Justin from French Country France. They have a lot of gorgeous brocante finds in their home. Domaine Sauvage. This is a couple, Anisha and Philippe, and their little son Odin from Belgium, who are also renovating an old farmhouse. I also enjoy following the journey of Isis and Bertus from Strois from the Cascina. They live in Piemonte, Italy. And of course, Martijn Dolaert, who also lives in Piemonte. And last but not least, my YouTube friend Carmine from the channel Red Leaf Hill, who lives in northern Norway with her husband and little children. The nature there is so beautiful. One day I come visit you, Carmine, there in real life, I know for sure. Those were a few of the many YouTube channels I follow. I set their channels in the description of this video. Do you also follow other people who are renovating or living in a new country?
Oh, je gaat nog meer op me klimmen.